Hello my friends, welcome to an exciting episode in our Photoshop design series. Like always, I'm going to show you how to design this flyer inside of Photoshop. So if you're not ready, get your gadgets set and let's start. In case I forget, the Smart Premium Graphic Designer asset is still very much available. Don't miss out on this offer to get your premium templates and backgrounds and fonts at affordable rates, right? So if you've not made your purchase, click on the link in the description of this video to get yours ASAP. And if you've not subscribed to my channel, what are you still waiting for? This is the best time to hit the subscribe button and turn on the post notification so you won't miss any of the videos I will be dropping anytime from now. Without having to say much, without further ado, let's get started. The first thing I'd like to do is click on File and click on New. Right, so over here, I'm just going to set my width and my height 5x5. And this is where I get to put the name of this design, right? So it's just going to be album cover let's see. So it's a mixtape cover and RGB transparent, and click on create like this. So I'm just going over to where I have my source file. I'm going to bring on the first element, right, which is this. This is going to be used for the background. I'm going to rotate this like this, and I'm just going to make it bigger this way, like this, right? And I'm just going to zoom in to see everything I'm doing in real time. So I have my background here, right? So next thing I'm going to do is go over to my text tool or my type tool, and I'm just going to type this. So click, it's going to bring out the Lorem Ipsum, and I'm just going to type what I need to type in. So for this, it's going to be whiskey, and of course I can decide to change. This is the font I use, Montserrat. So you can get all this font inside of the Smart Designer Premium asset. So this is another reason why you should get your asset. So you can always follow up in all my tutorials and use the same elements that I'm using, right? So click enter, and I'm just going to move it to the middle like this. Immediately I do that, I might choose to change the color or leave it the way it is, or use a black color. Let me change it back to where it was before. Just use this color. Yeah, let me just stick to this color because the background I'm going to be using for it, it's going to be a darker color. I'm just using this so you can see what I'm doing. Create a new layer directly above the background and select your pen tool. Make sure when you select your pen tool, it is set to shape, not path, right? So you want to turn off your caps lock and draw shape like this. Click here. Click here also. And Ctrl Z, click here. When you do a mistake, you can go back to Ctrl Z and click. So with this selected, with this done, I'm going to double click on the thumbnail. This is the thumbnail. Double click to change the color. I'm going to use black for this. Click OK. And for the whiskey itself, I'm going to go over to the properties. Let's see. Yeah, properties, color. And I'm going to change the color here with the color picker. So I'm just going to use this green color and click OK like this. All right. The next thing I like to do is select the two of them. That's the shape and the whiskey. And press Ctrl J to make a duplicate copy of this. Now you want to move this upwards like this and position this here. Make sure you have this tiny space in between the two of them. It's very, very good for the aesthetic of the general design that I would want to come out with for this mixtape. So double click on this, and I'm just going to write what I need to write here. This one is going to be money, so it's going to be whiskey money. And yeah, so this is going to be here, but I'm going to increase the size just so slightly like this. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color of this money. So how do I do that? Very simple. And yes, I think yes, just create a nice blend. Let's see. So double click here, and I'm just going to change the color to white, right? So I'm just going to leave it at white. I think this is good. And yeah, we're good to go. So next thing I'm going to do is go over to my pen tool, and this time I'm going to draw a shape here. So I'm going to start here from the beginning of the end, and I'm just going to draw a shape like this. It's not that perfect, but you can make yours perfect when you're trying to do yours too. And double click on the thumbnail for the shape. Sorry, that was not supposed to happen. And hold down shift while you're supposed to start from the beginning of the end. Make sure you don't forget that. Double click on the thumbnail and change the color to black. And push this down a bit like this. And there you go. Nice and easy. I'm going to make the duplicate copy of this whiskey. Ctrl J. I'm going to bring this down. I'm going to use this to write, make it smaller. So this is going to be click enter and double click on the thumbnail of the text to type mixtape. Just double click here to activate the text and just type mixtape like this. And that's all. So this is what I want to achieve, right? So I'm just going to make this slightly smaller. And this is good. Perfect like this. Nice and easy. And one thing I like to do again is, let me change this. I'm going to change this mixtape to yellow. So I have a nice blend of green, white, and yellow. I think that's like the color of a flag of a country. I don't really know. Right, so I'm clicking on money now. Click on money first. A couple of things I want to do here. Right click and go over to blending options. Now you need to pay attention to this part. When it opens up the blending option, a couple of things you need to do. First of all, click on bevel and emboss. Make sure it's grayed out and you click inside like this. When I mean click inside, this is the controls you need to work with. Now make sure you use these settings, right? Every of my settings that I use this, used all of my settings that I use here. Go over to contour, click again, and use all the settings that I used here, right? And when you're done with everything, you want to click OK like this, right? Great. So I'm just going to hold down the alt key, click on the FX, hold down the alt key, and drag on top of the whiskey. That's the first whiskey. You can see that I've copied the same effect. So this is how you can easily copy effects from one layer to the other inside of Photoshop. Yeah, you've learned something new. You're welcome. So it's whiskey money mixtape. So let's go on with the rest of the design. So what I'm going to do with this is I don't need to touch this, so I'm just going to move it upwards just slightly and make it bigger so you can actually feel its presence there. So whiskey money mixtape, we're good. That's the title. We've gotten the title. So I'm just going to select all of them and Ctrl G to group them all, so we have our layers flowing well. So you can see now I just have two layers here. We've analyzed all of these into one layer. So you can feel free to rename the layer. I'm just going to give it text. Simple, short, and easy. Right? So with this, I can Ctrl T and rotate it, and I'm going to use this angle like this, and I'm good to go like this. Make it slightly bigger. Still click enter when you're done. Okay, so now that that's out of the way, next thing I need to do is go over to my resource file, and not my resource file, I'm going to my download. I'm going to the graphics bundle 1.0. I also have mine, so I'm just going to open it up. I'm going to go into the premium PNG department. You can see you have lots of PNGs here, right? So I'm just going to scroll down. You can see that with all of this, you don't even need to go to the internet to search for things to use for your designs. You can get most of the things that you want to use inside here. So you'll be doing yourself a good favor if you get the Smart Designer Premium Assets. So I'm just going to drag this money. It's called bundle of money, bundle of dollars, as the case may be. So I'm just going to make it smaller like this, make it smaller to size the frame of the whiskey and the money. I don't want it to be too much more than that. Make it a bit smaller. Yes, and click enter when you're done. So I'm just going to drag it down so that the text is above the money, right? So I'm just going to make this bigger. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to make some adjustments to the money, make it pop, make it real, make it more real. So go over to filter, camera raw, and what you want to do inside camera raw is pretty simple. A couple of settings and we're good to go. I'm going to start with texture, increase the texture like this. I'm going to also put my input for clarity and dehaze, and increase the texture, drop the blacks like this. And another thing I will not fail to do is add some vibrance, and when I'm done, I'm going to click on OK like this, and this is what you have, right? Good. So it's giving me that old vintage kind of vibe, exactly what I want, right? So immediately on top of this, on top of the background, create a new layer here. And what you should do is, I'm going to flip this, make sure my foreground color is set to black, and I'm just going to draw a shape that resembles the shape of the money. And I'm going to go to convert to smart objects. I'm going to go to blur, Gaussian blur, and I'm just going to increase the blur rate here. So you can push it a step above this, maybe like 23 or 24. But for me, I would like to leave it somewhere around here is good. So I'll be working with 47 and I'm good to go. Right? Great. So 47 is what I use for the blur. Okay. Nicely done. Okay, so the next thing I would like to do is go over to and select all of these and move it upward like this. Select all of them, move it upward. I'm going to move back a bit. And I'm going to make duplicate copy of the dollar itself, rotate it like this. And what I'm going to do with this is click on filter, right, click on blur, and click on Gaussian blur like this. So I'm just going to apply this blur to it. I think, okay, so this is fine, this is good. Click OK. I'm going to duplicate this, Ctrl J. I'm just going to bring this here, Ctrl T to activate the transform, rotate it like this while you make it bigger like this, and voila, that's all you need to do for this. Right, click enter and it's done. Right, so it's done like this. And what I want to do next is make sure you are selecting this layer, that's the text. And let's see. Okay, go over to your resource file this time, and I'm going to use from the premium bundle also, I'm going to use this background. So this is where I got my background. You can see that you have this background inside your composition. Click enter, and I'm going to change this to divide. You can see the nice effect it has created. So most times when you see some things that you like online popped up and everything, it's just a combination of your artistic intellect and your backgrounds and your elements coming together and working well. That's what gives you those things and makes your design stand out, right? So it's good to have these things in your arsenal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create some light effects. Of course, I'm using the yellow. So I'm using the linear dodge add. So what I'm going to do with this is Control T, hold down shift while you compress this to make it flat. And I'm just going to have this here, rotate it and make it bigger. I'm going to have one here. Duplicate this, Control J, and I'm going to have another one here. Drag this down here to create this one here. And the last one I'm going to do is I'm going to bring one here. Definitely not the last one. And I'm going to have another one again. Duplicate this and bring this down here. But I'm just going to flip this one, Control T, flip it like this so that it can take the position or the space of where this money is. I'm going to put it here so I have a little bit of lightning here. And I'll just have to just reduce this one just so slightly, like this. And there you go, nice and easy, right? So we have Whiskey Money Mixtape. So the next thing I like to do again is go over to the original resource file which I added to this, and I'm just going to go and bring in this, which is bring this in and have it on top there like that. And the next thing I like to do again is bring in something else quite different. But before I do that, I'm going to go over to photo filter, click on it and double click to change this color to a green color. Make sure you're using a green color. You can select the green here and select the green inside the color picker. Make sure it's a lighter green. You can see the effect this has on the design immediately, right? Make sure you copy my settings. The density is at 25, right? So it gives it this greenish money-like texture, right? So next thing I like to do again is go to adjustment layer and go to, let's see, brightness and contrast, and I'm just going to add a little bit of contrast to all of this to make it pop more. And so there you go, guys. This is how I created this. You can choose to add your bottle of whiskey inside of this design. That's why I added it. So this is how I created the Whiskey Money Mixtape inside of Photoshop. If you've not gotten your Smart Designer Premium assets, now is the time to get yours, and so that you can follow along in my tutorials that I'll be dropping anytime from now. You can watch my next tutorial just up here. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.